Let's talk about this. I want you guys to think about something real quick. I want you to think about this right here. Think about that. I want you guys to figure out what this is. All right. The first technique we're going to do is called a rotate double. And we're going to start from both knees because I want you to develop this motion. It's a level and direction change. Everything we've done up to this point has been a level direction change as far as offensive attacks. Head outside single, we change levels twice. Sometimes three times. I hit the shot, have to change levels to get to his leg. I drive up, there's a second level change. I change direction into him, circle back motion, right? I also change direction when I circle to my left to hit the shot, correct? So at least two direction changes, at least two level changes, just to get to my feet with a head outside single. Make sense? So here's where we're gonna start, and without a partner, I want you guys to correct me if I'm wrong here. Start on both knees, my toes are curled, my head is up, my back is straight. My hips are underneath me. I'm in a pretty solid stance right here, right? Only for the fact that I'm not on my feet, for all intents and purposes. This isn't a bad stance. From here, I'm going to step up. I'm going to change level and direction at the same time. Correct me if I'm wrong. This is a change in direction, correct? Did I change direction? Correct me if I'm wrong. This is a level change. Am I changing levels? Here to here. Did I change level? Okay, we're going to do both of those things simultaneously. So I can start right here, and without a partner, I've got a head outside single right here. My left leg is my turtle leg, my left leg will step up. I step it up as high as I possibly can. From here, my hands are going to lock. My right hand comes high, my left hand comes low. I windshield wiper my back foot, this foot that's tapped, and I change level and direction at the same time. This right here. Again, step up, rotate, change level. Step up, rotate, change level. That is all this motion consists of. Now, when I hit you with a partner, to start out, I'll tell the partner to sprawl. You guys will do this. I can't have a rotate double from this position. I am nowhere close to being in a stance. So here we go, with a partner. Mario. I want everybody to start just like this. I want to grab Mario's leg. Mario's going to do one thing. He's going to take his right leg back. Why? That's the leg I'm shooting at. Of course he's going to take that back. From here, my trail leg is going to step up, and I step my trail leg up as high as I can. At the same time my trail leg steps up, my right hand unlocked, comes right here below his butt cheek. My left hand comes down here low on the calf. I do this. I step my trail leg up. Now, I have to rotate or change directions. And I have to change levels. I do this. My elbows pull back in my stance. I change level and direction here, shifting all the way to Mario's what leg? Left leg. And I told you Monday morning, we're going to shift the weight to his left leg, left hand, left knee, left foot all week long, right? Did I lie to you? No. Shifted all the way to his left hand, left knee. From here, notice, my trail leg is still up, all right? I am pointed across Mario's hips. My left hand is still on his calf. My right hand is still here on the hamstring. From this position, my right hand, which is on the hamstring, will let go. I will reach across here to the double, and I will simply drive across. Think about this as rotate to a double. Here's how I yell it out. Pose, head outside single, rotate double. Inside tie, collar tie. Head outside single, rotate double. Defensive angle. What do you have to do if I yell out rotate double? Sprawl. You gotta sprawl for it, alright? Do exactly what Mario's doing. Right now, we'll get to where we take this shot to finish, but I want you to figure out the mechanics of this technique first, then we'll take the shot to finish. Because you guys still have to figure this out. Sprawl. From here, my trail leg steps up high. My right hand comes high, my left hand comes low. I do this right here. At the same time I'm stepping up, my hands drop, my left hand drops, my right hand comes high, I change level and direction here, I pull down on Mario's leg. Why do I pull down? To shift all the way here to his left hand, left knee. I'm right here. I am in a good what? I'm in a good stance right here. Your left hand can never leave this calf until you're about to get this. I have to keep his leg isolated right here. I also, things you guys mess up, you'll take your left hand and you'll reach. And If I remove my left hand from Mario's leg and I start to reach, go ahead, Mario, do what you do in the match. He's going to go ahead and pull that leg back, and I end up with my forehead on the mat. I don't want that. Also, notice my left leg is up. I'm not here on both knees. If I'm here on both knees, is there any pressure on you, Mario? No pressure at all. My trailer leg is still up, so I can drive in to Mario. My right hip is not on the mat, only my right knee. My right knee will never move. My right knee is right here until I start to drive. So don't do this. Don't sit to your butt. If I sit here, I've got no power. Does it look like I have any power right here? No. Those are three big things that you guys usually do that I don't want you to do. So we're just going to start right here. Here's all we're going to do. He sprawls, go ahead. Am I carrying a little bit of Mario's weight? Yes. Is my head still up? Is my back still straight? Are my hips still underneath? Got to maintain my stance from here. Right hand high, left hand low. Look at my right knee. It's in the same hole on the mat. My right knee is my pivot point. This is what allows me to change direction and level. If I move my right knee, it forces me to go to my hip. So don't move your knee. Just change direction. Just do this. And pull down and shift the weight right here to Mario's left leg, left hand. From here, my right hand, let's go. I reach for the double and I drive. You guys with me on this? Does anybody want to see it again? One more time. Head outside single, rotate, double. He sprawls with his arms forward. I have to carry his weight right here for just a little bit. And you have to get the mechanics of this down. Once you have the mechanics down, taking a shot to finish is going to be easy if you figure out this. Here, my trail leg steps up high. As high as I can step up. Look, my knee hasn't moved. My right knee has not moved. Right hand high, left hand low. I pull down. My elbows come back into my stance. My shoulder stays on the inside here. Here, from this position, my right hand lets go. I shift in front, and I drive across his hips. Turn right hand. You guys with me? Start out on both knees. Partner, take your right leg back. Let's do it. 1, 2. Separate. I see a lot of people keeping their hands locked. Hey, not a bad decision, but you'll see here in a little bit. I haven't lied to you yet, have I? Have I lied to you at all yet?
No.
So trust me, I'm telling you, unlock your hands. It'll make sense when we take this shot to finish. Alright? It'll make sense when we take this shot to finish. I have to separate my hands. I have to keep Mario's leg isolated. From here, I want you to see this. He sprawls. If I step up and I leave my hands locked, even if I get the weight shifted to his left knee, left hand, even if I do this, my hands are locked. From here, Mario can still square up and sprawl. Go ahead, Mario. He can still square up and sprawl. If I have my left hand here on the calf, what I'm doing is putting torque on his knee, that's twisting pressure. I'm basically looking to blow his knee out if he squares up. I'm not actually trying to blow my partner's knee out. But if he tries to square up with me from here, it's going to force him to blow his knee out or stay in this position. Does that make sense? Kind of like you got somebody in the arm bar to hold you down or something like that. This is the arm bar on his leg, so we'll call it a leg bar, so to speak. This keeps him still and in this position. So my right hand can shift here to the front and drop. You got to unlock those hands. You guys are getting the motion level. The direction of the level change now. I just need you to unlock your hands. Pull my elbows back from the stance. Alright? Left hand, left knee. Last time I'm telling you, don't be a wimp, fall to your hip, and lay on your back. Alright?